This is a five-piece parable that we removed a lot of. You can demonstrate what it's called, the slide hammer. The slide hammer is So first thing we're going to do is take the hanger off.
The hammer mode busts it loose, and then the rotary mode just spins it. You may want a little more water on that.
So is this what we want in here, the split shaft?
Okay. Yeah, is that heavier?
Yeah. You kind of push it full, the button pushes hard, and if it locks up, you're going to go back to hammer.
There's need to get out of there. One of the things that, you know, the cone of the snake need to separate at some point. I'm not going to separate it until I put a tap on the inside of that sleeve. I'm going to keep it together.
He's got a nice big hammer.
Lots of times I can take the other sleeve right out. Sometimes I can push it out. Usually that can come right out.
A little more water.
Then there's the expansion sleeve. Sometimes you can push that out or just drill it out.
That's the trouble I've had with this.
It's a finesse part. You gotta get it just lined up right.
I'm gonna tap a thread on the inside of that sleeve.
Don't pull or push, just try to get
it. We're using a 9mm tap.
Yeah, you don't have to pull very hard.
He's
got it from Harbor Freight.
Wow.
Yeah, 600 was what they had. Who knows? But that's not carbide. So go back to hammer mode.
If I tap too far, I'm going to tap into the cone. That's got a different thread. So I want to make sure that dual bill part, get all the sleeve.
Get pretty hot. So
somebody has some water.
You don't need to push in much, because that's gonna narrow the collar.
Now the hole is kind of dirty, and I want to
push it in. You're really grinding the thinnest portion down. You want to be pulling more than pushing, because if you thin this up too much, when you go to pull, it just breaks. You want to damage the, you know, that end. So you want to be,
so this is,
you know, pulling that collar in.
This is without a hydraulic.
Just scoring a line. So that's our goal.
One thing
goal.
I didn't do.
Score a line.
Now that I have threads on the sleeve, I need to separate the sleeve and the cone.
Light outward pressure until it binds up.
By 16 is bold, it's going to go through the sleeve.
It's still binding up really easily. That means that it's sliding and it's wedging. It's still an active bolt. When it gets harder, what you're feeling for is when I pull back on it, is it keep spinning or not? If it's still spinning when I'm pulling out on it, then it's been damaged. So if you can pull out pretty hard and it doesn't catch, it's probably ready to pull it in. But if it binds up, yeah, it's like, I can go on a little further, make sure you damage the wedge. Push in.
When you're removing a really rusty bolt, it's important to get into the sleeve part
enough
and pull it all out. Otherwise, it comes out the
loose. So
take it, it can really be difficult to
peel off pieces of it. And then we're going to remove the spinner.
John, did you use a 9mm?
Use a 9mm.
Let me grab another crescent. Look at that.
So I didn't go in far enough. There's more sleeve in there. Sometimes you can fish it out with a magnet.
Well, anyway, the grinder,
you have to go in after a grinder.
John, is that a special tap that you guys have made?
You can use a 3/8-16 tap. This is a 9mm tap. This is a little bit narrower and a little bit easier than 12mm.
We have some right
here. There's a drill it out. So the bottom of that sleeve is still in there in three pieces. You know what they look like? They're the three legs of that. Well, sometimes they can get kind of hard to get out. I usually count how many threads I go in so I can make sure that this is far enough. I didn't get up this time.
Now I see it's kind of
remove the hanger, and if you see that there's a mobile hole, it looks like a...
If I put this in too far, it's going to go into the cone, or it's going to expand, make it difficult to get out. So the finesse thing, practice.
That blew my mind.
Yeah. I was like,
oh, look at that.
There's the three pieces I was trying to get out. I should have got more time, but it would be good. So, the last part that's in there is the toe. Right? It shouldn't be too difficult. Again, I like to have a clean hole,
right?
Get it out. Lots of time to be like, it's covered. So, I don't have to have more than one side hammer, but I do have this case just for time. So I have a 5/16 head on here to get the
irony of that.
Again, I don't want to go too deep. I just need to get enough threads out of that cone that it'll attach.
Woo!
We can do the same thing with a half inch as well. This is a 7/16-20, and I have a 7/16 tap. So we can do the same thing on the inside of a half inch. I have a half inch installed in one of these rocks, and we'll remove it a little bit later.
Great.